they called her the Lucky Herndon, the first one in at Normandy. What could it possibly have felt like to be on the ship on D-Day? The crew tells it best.
D-Day's almost here. Boy, the waiting around is nerve-wracking. The dope is that they're giving us only 1 in 10 chance. But they don't know this ship. I wish I could be home right now, but I wouldn't miss this for anything. History's gonna be made, and I'm gonna be a part of it.
June 6th, the day we've been told so much about and waited for so long has finally come. At 0300 hours, we anchored with France in sight. Our Air Force was bombing the beach. There must have been 3,000 planes overhead. Boy, they really were letting them have it. But there were planes being hit too plenty, and 12 American boys were dying.
At 0330, we are underway. We're supposed to fire the first shot. At 0459, we are tracking our first target, Target 34. Everyone topside can see France. We've been expecting the enemy shore batteries to open up on us at any moment.
It's difficult to write this because the ship is shaking so much. The beach is so close you can see the houses. At 0635, the first troops are landing. There are ships all over the horizon. One convoy after another is coming in. They are landing the troops on the beach in droves. Daylight was getting bright, and I felt a great chill of fear as I realized how close we had come to the beach. When we opened fire, it seemed like a combination of an earthquake and all of the volcanoes in the world erupting at the same time.
We could see our men storming the beach, trying to gain a foothold. Under our naval fire, the troops were enlarging the beachhead. As the Germans reeled back, our shells were landing farther and farther inland.
Before darkness on D-Day, the Air Force sent over hundreds of glider planes, towed by transports. They were carrying troops and supplies to the established beachheads. It was one of the most impressive sights I have ever seen. This day, D-Day, is a day the Germans will never forget. They have taken the beating of their lives. However, we lost a lot of young men in the Navy, the Army, the Air Corps, the Coast Guard, and the Merchant Marines.
Tom Wilmore was only 17 when he enlisted. He lied about his age to join the Navy.
We got in there just a little 412, and the captain gave us a pep talk, just like football team manager or baseball manager or your mother and dad or anything else. And he told us our assignment and what we was going to do. And America was expecting us to do it, and we were going to do it. And we weren't supposed to survive at all. And it was announced we were going to lead them into Normandy and be the first to go to the beach.
A beach thousands of Americans and allies stormed. A beach where thousands lost their lives.
It's just unbelievable the amount of material and ships and things you saw in there. The ocean just almost was solid ships, but it was bad.
When ground troops at Omaha Beach needed offshore artillery support, the Herndon moved in close to the beach, targeting German gun mounts.
All we had to do is hit them enough and start killing people around there, and then they would shoot at us. And when they'd shoot at us, that was the end of that P.O. box, because the battle wagons and all that would take care of it. There's no way in the world this man here can experience what I experienced. It'll never happen again that way.
My name is Frank Luxa. I was assigned to the USS Herndon, DD-638. Was the last ship in the Normandy invasion, Omaha Beach. And I want to thank the Herndon Band for honoring us in 2019 in Normandy.